this in the world. All right, well, we still have a few more things we can do here. Good evening. I would like to invite our class president, Leandra Rodriguez, to the microphone to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please remain standing for our national anthem. Mrs. Cynthia? I want to welcome everyone here to Hoboken High School's commencement exercises for the class of 2015. I wish to extend a warm welcome to the parents and families of all our graduating seniors. Dr. Raquel, Dr. Hernandez, Mr. Moffitt, Mr. Callaghan, our new superintendent of schools, Dr. Christine Johnson, our Board of Ed members, Ms. Tyrola, Mr. Klepfel, Ms. Angley, Mr. Biancamano, Ms. Evans, Dr. Gold, Ms. Mitchell, Ms. Soloff, and Ms. Stromo. Mayor Zimmer and City Council members, as well as Freeholder Romano. I would be remiss if I didn't thank and introduce my amazing administrative team, Mrs. Bello and Mr. Sonye. And I also want to say at Hoboken High School, there are so many people that work every day with your children. Some have worked with them longer than others, but they are there every step of the way to ensure they stand with all of us today. Mr. White, Ms. Weiner, Mr. England, and all the amazing faculty and staff are to be thanked for their continuous work. And last, but certainly not least, Mr. Sorfine and Ms. Denhai, thank you so much for your time, energy, and enthusiasm, ensuring that all students have memorable 4 years at Hoboken High School. I recently attended my nephew's graduation out in Atlanta, Georgia. And during one of the speeches, I was reminded of a childhood book, Harold and the Purple Crayon. I'm not sure if anyone here remembers that book. It was written in 1955, but that book has stood the test of time. For those who don't know it, Harold is a young, curious boy, and he has a purple crayon. But it's not an ordinary crayon. This crayon has power. It has the power to create a world by simply drawing with it. If Harold wanted to walk in the moonlight, then there was no moon he could draw one. Take a moment and just imagine having a crayon like that. And I want to remind you that you do. Perhaps not the magical crayon that Harold has, but what you have is opportunity. You have your experience, and most importantly, at the end of this exercise, you will have your diplomas. The only thing you have to do is imagine your future. Take the tools that we have instilled in you over the years and draw it out. That sounds easy, but it's not always so. Please continue your drawing. If you wind up down a path that you do not find happiness in, draw another path. And if that one doesn't work, draw a new path. Keep drawing until you find that path that leads you to happiness. And when you reach that path, I expect that you'll all give 150%. Harold has a lot of adventures in this book, and it's a short book, so I encourage you to read it. I can only hope that your life provides you with the adventures that you want. The nice part to remember that is in this book, Harold ends up drawing his own house, which is where his journey ends. You should all know that wherever your dreams take you, no matter how many paths you go down, you can always draw Hoboken High School and you can come home. Whenever I hear a graduation speech, it seems like people are always saying, we've given you so much over the past 13 years, and we have given so much and talked so much at you. But I always see it differently. Every year I feel blessed because I feel like I've gained over the years so much from you. Thank you, good luck, and remember you are always welcome here. At this time I'd like to call up our valedictorian Leandro Rodriguez and our salutatorian Jonathan Aviles and welcome Mayor Zimmer to the
truly an honor to be here with all of you on this very, very special occasion. So I want to thank Principal Pietra, teachers and staff, and to all your friends and family who are here for this very, very important event. To the graduates, we are so proud, the city of Hoboken is so proud of all that you have accomplished. So there's a lot of people that deserve thanks for today. Your teachers, your school administrators, staff and school board, and your family and friends, and everyone who has helped you learn, grow, and mature into young adults. But ultimately, you are here because you put in the time and effort, and you all deserve so much credit. And I especially want to thank and invite up our valedictorian, Leanza Rodriguez, and salutatorian, Jonathan Aviles, for your exceptional accomplishments. So Jonathan, I love the glasses. I want to wish you an extended congratulations for receiving the prestigious full scholarship to Stevens Institute of Technology. And I will say as the mayor of Hoboken, it's always refreshing to see such talented students from our school system continuing their higher education right here in Hoboken. And Leanza, among your many accomplishments, I want to say again, I think you've heard me say this a few times, but I want to say it to everyone here. I was so impressed with your leadership as president of the Hispanic Culture Club and the documentary you helped create. It was your vision for Habla Hoboken. If you haven't seen it yet, I want to encourage everyone to find it on YouTube or we put it out on the city's Facebook page. I think everyone should take a look. The documentary is a thoughtful production on breaking down cultural stereotypes that many of our students face on a daily basis. I want to thank each and every one of the students that participated in that video for telling your powerful stories about the search for your own identities. It isn't easy to talk about the difficult subject of race and ethnicity, but your stories are so important to encouraging more children and young adults to become comfortable in their own skin. And not only did everyone in the documentary serve as role models to your fellow classmates and younger students, you sent a message to people of all ages and backgrounds that talking about these difficult subjects is not only just okay, it should be encouraged. So I want to thank everyone involved in that Habla Hoboken, and they deserve a big round of applause. And finally, I'm so impressed with all that's happening at Hoboken High School. And on a personal note, as a parent, I'm very excited that my son Alex will be attending Hoboken High School next year. So I want to say to Leonza and to Jonathan and to the class of 2015 a huge congratulations on behalf of the city of Hoboken. I want to present these proclamations, and let's hear it for our valedictorian, salutatorian, and the class of 2015.
Thank you, Ms. Emmer. This past year, we were fortunate enough to have an interim superintendent that allowed us to continue the great work in Hoboken and keep our forward momentum going. This year has been great, and we wish Dr. Raquel well on his new endeavors. Please help me in welcome interim superintendent, Dr. Raquel.
Well, I have to explain the blue robe. I want to thank everybody for the opportunity to serve as the interim superintendent in Hoboken. And believe me, I'm 100% Hoboken. This is not from another high school. This is the Seton Hall doctoral robe, and that's why I'm wearing it. Otherwise, I'd be in red. But I want to welcome everybody and thank you all for the opportunity to say a few words to you tonight on this glorious night. As I was planning my comments for tonight, some very real and provocative questions came to mind. What do graduates really need to know on graduation night? Do they need a walk down memory lane for reminders of the past? Do they need advice? Do they need comments from a speaker or an author or a playwright? More than these questions, what will the graduates remember about what's being said? I think back to my own graduation from high school. Not only don't I remember what was said, I don't even remember who said it. All right, now look, some of you are probably thinking, well, that's a long, long time ago, so we give him a few, he's forgotten a few things, but I admit that might be part of it. But my point in all of this is that I want to tell you something that is meaningful in your lives and easy to remember. And I found it in an address delivered by playwright Susan Laurie Parks to a graduating class in Mount Holyoke in the early 2000s. In that address, as a former Mount Holyoke graduate, Parks brings to the graduates 16 suggestions to navigate through life. Not recommendations, not requirements, no speeches, just 16 humble suggestions. So I'd like to bring them to you tonight. Number one. Cultivate the ability to think for yourselves. Listen to your heart and tune into your gut. Don't let anyone pull you where you don't want to go. Embrace discipline as an extension of your own well-being. Practice patience. Keep walking your road and things will come to you when you're ready to receive them. As you walk your own road of life, relish that road and understand that it's going to take twists and turns all along the way. Make soap purses out of pig's ears and lemonade out of lemons, you all know that one. For every TV show you watch, read a poem. For every book you read, spend time in the mall shopping. Cross-train your spirit. Again, on that road of life, get out of your own way, and when you walk, try all these new things that come along. Splurge now and then. Do something you love. Eat your vegetables. Floss your teeth. Try meditation. Get some exercise. Sharpen your senses, especially your sense of humor. Say thank you. And love yourselves. Why not? Years from now, who among you will remember these words? Maybe some will, maybe a lot won't. But anyway, my dear graduates, whether you do or not, tonight is a night where you're saying something to yourselves and to the audience and your parents. That is, you are showing all of us that you have met the challenges of the last 13 years and you're ready to begin the rest of your lives outside of Hoboken High School. Oh, and by the way, that leads me to suggestion number 16. Be bold, have faith, that you will live the kind of life that you want to live. And as you begin moving towards that wish, it will begin to move toward you. I've come to know some of you in my short time here as your interim superintendent, and I'm confident that as you enter the world of adults, the world will be a better place through you. We'll miss you. Goodbye, good luck, and Godspeed. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Brockhill. At this point, I'd like to ask Ms. Tyrola, President of the Board of Education, to step up to the podium.
Class of 2015, parents, family and friends, school administrators, teachers, Mayor Zimmer, and distinguished guests, as President of the Board of Education, it is an honor and a pleasure to address you on this special evening. I want to discuss two things with you on this important day. I call them firsts and onlys. So what am I talking about? A first is exactly that, a first time that you experience something. A first time can bring all types of emotions, excited, scared, happy, apprehensive, sad. All through our lives, we experience firsts. As we get older, these firsts get farther and farther apart. Onlys are those events that only happen once in a lifetime. They, like firsts, become less frequent as we get older. So let's think about that. Let's think about a baby. A baby can experience multiple firsts in one day. For instance, a baby can eat carrots, peas, and see a dog for the first time all in one day. We've all watched YouTube videos of babies tasting carrots and what that face looks like versus babies tasting ice cream. So when we're little, we probably certainly had days where we've experienced first-time tsunamis of firsts and things that are happening. Think about a trip to the zoo where you might see animals, lions, and tigers all at the same time. Firsts that are exciting to have. At this point, your lives have had many firsts. You've learned to ride a bike, you've slept over a friend's house, you may have eaten sushi, you've hit your first home run, you even might have your first gray hair. Oh, wait a minute, I meant you gave your mother her first gray hair. You may have also had your first kiss. Up until today, most of your firsts have been about growing up, shared by many of your classmates around you. That is changing. There is a whole world to discover. There are an infinite number of firsts to experience. Today happens to be an only. You only graduate from high school once. So right now, take a moment to think about how you feel today. The excitement, the nervousness, savor the feeling of embarking on a new stage of your life. Parents and guardians, you have spent the last 17 or 18 years watching your children's firsts. You are also starting a new stage, a whole new set of first experiences to see with your child. You will probably hear about them via text. They might say, "I got it," when they're talking about winning a job. "I want you to meet someone, a future partner in life." "I passed," maybe the bar exam. "We're having a baby." All these things will be firsts that you get to experience with your children. Please remember to stop and savor these moments too. As your son or daughter's life gets busy, as adults' lives do, you need to remind your child to take the time to feel and enjoy these future milestones when they occur in their lives. Congratulations, class of 2015. Live life to its fullest. In the end, it's not going to matter how many breaths you took, but how many moments took your breath away. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Tyrola. At this point, I'd like to call Mr. Stasiak up to the, along with Jason Olivares, Rebecca Manillo, Steve Fuentes, Lionel Rivera, and Justin Algren for a performance of Titanium.
Thank you.
School system since pre-K. He's a young man of quiet character, but beneath the surface of fierce ambition, incredible work ethic, determination, and intellectual curiosity. These qualities are going to serve him very well for the years to come, especially as he heads down the road to Stevens. Please help me in welcoming the class of 2015 salutatorian, Jonathan Billy.
Friends of family again. We are here today to see my class, the class of 2015, begin the next stage of our lives. I assure everybody that this speech will only be about 4 to 5 minutes long.
Someone should time me just to make sure. All right. For most of us here, we have been in Hoboken High for 5 years.
It has been a long and tedious journey, but this moment is what we have been working and striving for in our academic career. Despite being a small class, in my eyes, we had the best and greatest time doing all of our class activities, such as prom, trips, class fundraisers, all of it. It was awesome. And
there is a line.
Okay. There's a line from the song I know. Pretty sure my class knows the song as well. The man says, "I'd rather 10 lions than 100 sheep." Surround yourself with leaders rather than followers.
You are who you hang out with.
Their personalities and ideas rub off on you. Be around people
who have similar goals to your own. Each one of you
guys sitting here have the
utmost potential to succeed in life.
Each one of you guys can accomplish what you want most, but only by working for it. It may not be working in the specific moment, but working hard for weeks, months, or even years.
All of it is up to you. You are the only
obstacle in your path to success.
In life, there will be people who chase money. Even though money is good and it provides the essentials, it isn't everything in the world. Like my girlfriend, Crystal Wallace, once said, more money, more problems. What everyone should be striving for in life is achieving happiness in what you do. Life becomes cumbersome if you are not happy in what you are doing. Always do what makes you happy. Money is sure to follow. But whatever you decide to be, whether it's a professional athlete, personal trainer, doctor, nurse, computer engineer, lawyer, businessman, whatever it may be, always try your best. That is when you will be happy and become wealthy. My final words to my class will be, do not let anyone tell you you cannot succeed. Some of the most famous and successful people throughout history were terrible. They were not making. Michael Jordan was cut from his high school basketball team. Steve Jobs, the creator of Apple, went through constant trial and error, and even went through a financial crisis before he made Apple the tech giant it is today. The Beatles, one of the greatest bands of all time, were rejected by Decca Records and deemed unmusical.
What do they all have in common? They persevered and achieved what they want because they believed in themselves and did not heed to the ridicule made by others. They know what they wanted and they did what they loved. It obviously paid off in the end. In the years to come, I wish every single one of you guys the best of luck in your future endeavors. A wise man once told me, if the sky was the limit, there wouldn't be footprints on the moon.
Nicely done, thank you. So valedictorian. Valedictorian has achieved the highest average in our class over 4 years. But that's only part of what makes this young lady great. She has also distinguished herself outside of the classroom with an array of sports, clubs, and community activities. She can be described with many wonderful qualities, but resiliency is the best word to describe her. She never settles for mediocrity, and I love the story that she walked into her guidance counselor, Mr. White's office, beginning of her ninth grade, and told him she was going to be a valedictorian. Congratulations, Leonza Rodriguez. You did it.
Before I commence my speech, I would first like to thank a few people. I would like to thank our principal, Ms. Pietro, our vice principal, Mrs. Vello, Mr. Sorkin, Ms. Denai, Ms. Wiener, and of course, the rest of the high school staff and the administration. In particular, I would also like to say thank you to Mr. White, who I have probably driven crazy by now because I sat in his office practically every single day this year. I want to thank Ms. Stevens for being the toughest but best English teacher I have had thus far. Woo! You have made me a better writer, creator, reader, and analyst. Because of you, I have discovered a new side to the writer I am. You have become the image that appears in my head when I think of the writer I'd like to be someday. I would also like to thank Mr. Munoz. You have been by my side since I first met you 5 years ago. You have played a critical role in my development as a student, leader, and as a person. You have seen me blossom and grow. You have basically been a second father to me at school.
I will stop here because I don't want to cry. And you already know how much I appreciate having met you. I want to thank two wonderful friends that helped me make one of my dreams for today a reality with their amazing artistic skills. Lastly, but definitely not least, I want to thank my family and, of course, my friends. Without your support, encouragement, and love, I would not have the opportunity to stand on this stage and present my speech to all of you today. In the moments where I was prepared to give it all up, you have reminded me why I continue to work so hard. For all of this and more, once again, I thank you. Now it is time for me to take full advantage of the brief time allotted to me to share my speech with you. And as we all know, I can definitely talk. By now, I am sure many of you have realized that I am a writer. It is not only what I love to do, but who I am. However, rather than just use words to convey my message, I have decided to use a few visuals. Here I have a picture, a color by number. I'm sure many of you remember this when we were little. This picture is cut up into different sections, and each section has a number. On the bottom of the paper, it tells us to fill in certain sections with specific colors based on the number inside. When we first look at this picture, it is blank. This is us as freshmen, a blank canvas, an open space that can be used as we choose to. At first, we have some uncertainty on what to do with this picture. So we color it in based on the colors we are told to use. This makes the process so much easier, doesn't it? Just following the instructions given. Then, as sophomores, we fill in more of the blanks, but get a little tired of the same routine. Nothing is going on in this picture. It hasn't changed much, and things seem to be getting boring. So we eagerly look for change. But wait, this is what junior year looks like. We begin to use different colors, bold colors, vibrant patterns, and color outside the lines because we have finally realized that there are no or should not be any guidelines to coloring in the perfect picture. Is there only one way to paint this perfect picture? Or can we try a different method to create our own beautiful picture? We begin to question the ideas we believed when we were just a few years younger and begin to take risks. We begin to fill in the areas that are meant to be pink with orange and those meant to be red with green. At a certain point, we may not like the way certain colors blend, but from those moments, we then learn what we do like and what colors should come together. Finally, it is senior year. I'm sure I can speak for all, if not most of us, when I say that we worked hard, endlessly, through frustration and exhaustion, thinking that our piece was finally done, and it was now time to put it up on display. Wrong. This is where finishing this picture gets difficult. With all of the craziness of classes, applying to college, applying for scholarships, the worries about financial aid, and in my case, making sure I maintain my grades in order to be on this exact spot, we begin to just scribble our way through the rest of the picture, not too sure about what the final product will be, just hoping it all works out. Today we realize what a masterpiece it turned out to be, not only because everything turned out the exact way it was supposed to, but because this wonderful, magnificent, Van Gogh-esque picture is ours, and ours only. We should all be proud of that art piece that we have finally dedicated 4 years to. Now, it is time to work on college. So let me ask you all a question. Has there ever been a time where you wished you could just make the world yours and live without judgment, or fear of rejection. This is your time to do it. I once heard in a movie that it doesn't matter what labels are thrown your way because only you can define yourself. So go on, begin living, begin exploring, begin filling in your picture, because something tells me these pictures are going to be great. Remember, nobody can fill in our picture. So go do you, be you, class of 2015, just as long as you never forget where you came from, my fellow Red Wings. Congratulations, Hoboken High School, class of 2015. We did it! And I hope we're all prepared, because today marks day one of the story of the rest of our lives. High school is only the first picture in our gallery that will soon be filled with so many more masterpieces. Thank you, and congrats once again.
Thank you, Lianza. At this time, I'd like to call up Dr. Markell and Board President Ruth Tyrola to certify our graduates.
Board of Education President Ruth Tyrola, I certify that these seniors from Hoboken High School have satisfied and completed all the graduation requirements under the New Jersey Administrative Code and the Hoboken Board of Education, and I recommend to you that tonight they are official graduates.
On behalf of the whole Board of Education, I proudly say yes, we accept your recommendation.
I ask that Mr. Sonia, the Supervisor of Student Support Services, come up to the podium at this point so we can get to the main event.
Justin Algarin. Anthony Alisea. Mariah Almonte. Isaiah Anderson. Alicia Antoinette. Justin Aponte. Juan Arenas. Jonathan Aviles. Juan Bernhardt Derris. Gabriela Clemente. Daniel Clifford. Selena Clifford. Michael Colon. Cruz. Angel Daniels. Lane English. Gianni Fiola. Jacob Vermeint. Kevin Figueroa. Jonathan Garcia. Destiny Gidden. Clarissa Gonzalez. Eric Gutierrez. Danasia Hicks. Precious Law. Julissa Lopez. Kiera Maldonado. Rebecca Manillo. Preston Mars. Jalinda McDonald. Amy Mendez. Elijah Mercado. Joshua Mercado. Jarius Mills. Andrew Mitchell. Ramel Mixon. Okay, John Mirardelli. Isaiah Neidert. Stephen Normandia. Christian O'Connor. Daniel Ocasio. Naomi Olasio. Jason Oliveris. Stephanie Oseguera. Daniel Padilla. Jessica Perilla. Alexander Perelson. Brianna Perez. Amani Prince. Kelly Ramirez. Jason Ramos. Lydia Richards. Angel Rivera. Ashley Rivera. Derek Rivera. Lionel Rivera. Thank you. Sarah Rivera. Joshua Robles. Ricky Roeder. Angelica Rodriguez. Carlos Alberto Rodriguez. Kimberly Rodriguez. Lienza Rodriguez. Aracelis Rojas. Joshua Rosa. Stephanie Selby. Michael Sedano. Samantha Tirado. Brittany Torres. Nick Valenti. Marina Wardell. Keonti Welch. Deshauna Williams. Michael Williamson. Michael Wilson.
At this time, I ask the graduating class to please rise. Remove our tassels from the right to the left. I present to everyone the graduating class of 2015. Okay. So I also want to invite parents over to the park after the exercise, after the students exit. We spoke to the town, they're going to give us the park, the gazebo is cleared out for us, so there's some great spots for pictures. I want to thank you all for coming, and I want to thank you for all for entrusting your children to us. We've been fortunate to have them for the past 12, 13 years. So with that said, Mrs. Stasia. Go, go, go!